morning and welcome to Cooking with Sally J. This is take two, guys, because last time was bad. We are going to start out by making donuts. And I think I'm going to do three separate segments because I like plain donuts. And then there's a chocolate donut recipe that is my husband's mother's that he enjoys. And then molasses donuts, which is just a favorite of a lot of people. These we make at camp meeting. So this donut recipe and the molasses one, when we do it, are from Nola Pendexter. The chocolate one will be from Bruce's mom. There's some ingredients that I change because I like them better. I've already put in a cup and a half of sugar in the bowl because I messed up the last time and I wasn't going to measure back out. So there's a half a cup of sugar in your bowl. And then it calls for a half a teaspoon of cream of tartar. That's what I substituted. I don't like cream of tartar as well as I like Bakewell. And Bakewell's great because you just use it spoonful for spoonful, whatever the recipe says. If you're going to use it in a substitute for baking powder or baking soda, you need to follow the directions because that does change a little bit. Okay, so in this little cup is a half a teaspoon of cream of tartar, a teaspoon of salt, and a teaspoon of baking soda. So we're going to dump that right in on top of the sugar. And then we have 3 tablespoons of lard. Now I'm going to start my machine here to start incorporating it. I know you guys, my machine's loud, but I like my machine. Okay, so you're going to have that pretty much on medium right now, and you just start adding your other ingredients, which is 1 teaspoon of vanilla, 2 eggs, one and a half cups of buttermilk. And I'll talk to you about the buttermilk after I shut the machine off. Okay, the buttermilk, the recipe does call for buttermilk. And I like using the buttermilk. But if you do not have buttermilk, you can just sour some milk. And how you would do that is you would take a cup of milk, a teaspoon of vinegar, and just let it set for a few minutes. And a teaspoon of baking soda. So a teaspoon of vinegar, a teaspoon of baking soda to 1 cup of milk, and just let it set a minute, and that will do whatever buttermilk does. It sours it a little bit. But if I can get the buttermilk, I get it, and I don't buy it in the liquid. You can, I guess. I like it in the powder, and it keeps good in the refrigerator, so I have it when I need it. Okay, so start the beater again. Okay, so we've added everything but the flour. The flour can be tricky. You don't want your batter to be, you don't want it to be like bread. It needs to be a little bit sticky. So this recipe said enough flour. This recipe said enough flour to make it workable. Well, you know, I don't know what that means. So I just play with it, and I start out with 4 cups of flour. I felt myself wipe my nose, so I better wash my hands. I'm starting out with 4 cups of flour, and I'm just going to put it in slow. So I probably got 2 cups in there, and then I'll start my mixer. I'll start that on slow. Okay, and you're going to let that mix. My thing is backward to me because I needed an outlet. You needed to see me. Okay. So I'm going to add another cup. Oh, you guys. I'm leaving it. This is what happens. That's why, to be honest with you, I like to make my donuts in my pajamas, but that wasn't going to happen. Okay. Okay. So I'm thinking that is workable. Because you're going to put this in the refrigerator to cool. I just can't believe you just don't know how hard it is for me to do this stuff, and I gotta be me, people. Okay. So it kind of looks like that, and I don't think it's quite workable, so I'm just gonna add by hand with a beater, I'm gonna add the whole 4 cups. So there wasn't much left in that. Because you gotta remember, once you take it out of the fridge, the coolness of it will help it to be more workable. But you will be putting flour on your board. Okay, so this is pretty good. I will take it out and show you. It's almost like the consistency. Just a little stiffer than Play-Doh, you know. You want it to be sticky, okay? That's all I can say. So it's sticky, and you do not grease your bowl. Just find another bowl. The reason I'm transferring is I'm going to need this bowl later when I do another thing. Another recipe of it. Okay, so get it in your bowl. Rinse your hands off so you can handle the saran wrap. And then just stick it in your refrigerator 3 hours. I a lot of times will do it overnight. It just depends. So there you go. Hi, welcome to Cooking with Sally J. I always forget who I am. I have my third granddaughter, Chelsea, gonna help me today. She's gonna sugar the cookies as we deep fry them. So right now we're deep frying the plain donuts. And we put them in the hot grease, and you need to wait for them to come to the top, and then you need to flip them. And I'm a little weird in my kitchen because my kitchen is not level. And that makes a difference with the deep frying. And so I've got these cords rigged up. It's so unsafe, yet we're safe because I know what I'm doing, at least. I think I know. So Chelsea, smile at everybody and say hi.
Hi.
I love that my grandkids love their Grammy or their Mimi. They don't call me Grammy because that's like swearing. Mimi. And it's M-E-M-E for people that want to know, because it is all about me, but not really.
You got that right.
Not really. Okay, so they come to the top. So now we're gonna flip them. And you want them to be golden brown. So these are looking good. Then you're going to let them go about another minute or so, and then sometimes I flip them again and sometimes I don't. It just depends on what they're looking like, but these are looking pretty good. Nothing's falling apart on me. Bruce doesn't mind when they fall apart because he gets the fall apart ones.
Yum.
I do get impatient. Sometimes it takes time, so I'm just gonna go with it. We're gonna go out and pass out donuts after this. We're gonna do drive-bys and bless some other people.
Because we get blessed. Just so you're not bored, I'm going to show you something I got blessed with. I'll be right back. Somebody came to visit the other day, or stopped by, and they brought me these beautiful flowers. Every time I look at them, I know that God blesses. Which you all probably have stories too. All right, so now, that looks good. Come on in. This is my oldest granddaughter, Charlie girl.
Can't see her.
Oh, she won't come in because she's all shy.
I'm supposed to come in.
This is my oldest granddaughter, Charlie girl. Come here, please. Would you like to see her beautiful face? Come on. Now she's all blushy. She's 17. She's very smart. Chelsea is going to, when they cool off just a hair, she's going to throw them into the sugar bag.
One at a time or put them all in?
So you can put three or four in at a time.
Okay.
Don't be afraid of it. Just do it and shake them up.
Yes, ma'am.
Hot!
Okay.
Shake them up good. I don't zip it. You don't have to zip the bag. That takes too much time. Just hold it tight together and shake it. There you go. And then just take the donuts out and put them on the thing. You can leave some. Look how nice that one is. That's better than store-bought. Okay, just put them right on there. Because I want to shut the camera. Okay. So that's what your plain donuts, sugared or without sugar, would look like. I hope you enjoyed our segment on cooking plain donuts. Have a nice day.